Hey guys, right, sorry about that. Obviously I'm not 100% still, so I kind of had to like go away to take some time to like feel better. But right, what we're gonna do is we are continue this obviously beige. I'm gonna get rid of the took because I cut them bits up. Right, so the next thing I'm gonna do is obviously you've got here, which is like a bite mark. I don't know why I'm doing that. That means bite mark in my world. Yeah, so you've got like a little bite mark there, as you can see. And as again, as I said to you guys, I'm sorry. What you can do is you can cut this out and you can draw around it. You can like draw around it and everything. Obviously, just to get yourself. Obviously, as I said, if you're not very confident, drawer. So that way you've got yourself something to kind of like. To draw around, it gives you like a guideline, and sometimes that can really help. And that to me is like the best way to learn because then you get used to drawing the shapes and everything, and then you can go from there. I'm really sorry about my coffee, and as I said, I'm really not 100% still. Obviously, I've promised so many people that I'm going to continue doing these books for you guys. So yeah, I'm obviously like fighting through it for you. Right. Can't really show you it with that. Right, so what we're gonna do is we are gonna draw the teeth. So they're like here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do this. Obviously, as you guys can probably see, I've kind of got a tripod now, so it really does help. Because that was the other reason why I kind of stopped doing these videos was because I was getting frustrated, not with you guys, but for you guys, because you guys couldn't see properly what I was doing, and I can completely understand like anyone else's frustration, because I was getting frustrated like when I was watching them back, being like, I'm gonna put that up because that's me doing the page, but I'm getting frustrated, I said, for you guys, because you guys can't see exactly what I'm doing, and these type of videos, like you need to see kind of like everything, like what I'm doing. So, yeah, obviously, my sister was nice enough to donate this camera to me that comes with a really like little tripod, which is perfect for me. So it's awesome. The cat's killing something. I have no idea what she's killing. She's found a bit of paper or something, by the sounds of it. So, as I've said as well, like if this doesn't come out like 100%, like kind of as you were anticipating it, don't be like too downhearted, because it is supposed to be a journal. It's supposed to be his journal, obviously, throughout everything, which is awesome. But he doesn't do anything perfect within the book. Like all his drawings are doodles and stuff like that. So yeah, it is. Don't feel like that's what his book would have been. So. Don't worry yourself too much about it. I am obviously, once I finish this book, I will be doing other basic cosplay items, because I call this kind of a cosplay item. It's like something you'd have for cosplay. So if you guys want me to do another something else, let me know. It might be that you guys say want me to do the next like Gravity Falls book one, which obviously I've never done before, so I would have to research it. Perhaps you want me to do I don't know, the card captor cards, etc. Just let me know in the comments below anything that you'd like me to do next, and we can go from there. I'll see what everyone kind of wants me to do. I said if you want me to do the next bit in Gravity Falls, or if you want me to do something else from the Disney Channel. It might be a cartoon that I've never heard of. Obviously, I'm not gonna lie, I still kind of watch cartoons, still watch Disney Channel, etc. So yeah, let me know. If I haven't seen it, that's absolutely fine, because obviously then I get to see like an awesome new cartoon that I didn't know anything about. So I can obviously go that way ahead, and I can watch it and go from there. Or it might be one that I said like I have seen, and there's something in there. in the cartoon that you really want me to do, and we'll go from there, and we'll gradually work out, and we'll gradually do these bits bit by bit, and then we can do loads of tutorials on how to make these awesome things that are in these cartoons. And as I said, just let me know what you want me to do, and it might be if you guys come up with like enough good ideas that we can basically pair it off, in the sense of like, I'll do Gravity Falls on a Thursday, but I could do something else on a Wednesday, something else on a Tuesday for you guys, and we'll do it like that. So I think that's the best thing. So there is our teeth. As I've said, in previous videos, I don't particularly go over my drawings in black pen. I will go over the writing, etc., but I don't... leave that wire alone. I don't go over my drawings in black pen. That is my personal preference. If you wish to go over your drawings in black pen, please feel free to. Obviously, if you guys want to show me any pictures of what you've done so far, that would be awesome to see, because I'd love to see what everybody else has done. You know, how everyone's books are going. So that would really be awesome. I'd love to see that. See, they've got these little digs and marks in them. So that is our teeth. Now inside is the teeth. What you need to do is we need to do an exclamation mark, like so. I'll go over there now. Right, that is in black. Good. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my black felt tip pen, and I'm just literally going to go over this exclamation mark. And you do want to make this a bit like where we did the writing up the top, a little bit 3D. Yeah, I've actually been re-watching an old cartoon called Freephonics, which was on the CBBC channel, I believe. It could have been CBBC or CITV when I was a little bit younger. Well, I really shouldn't have been watching cartoons again, but hey-ho. Yeah, I've been re-watching that. I'm actually really enjoying that. So, right, so what I'm going to do is what I normally do. So I'm going to write what needs to go here, and then I will tell you guys exactly what I have written. Oh, that's good. So this bit is done. So this bit here reads, these teeth possess magical properties, which is stored inside A. It's underneath where the magic comes from, but it can face upon the unknown. That inability to lie responsibly by B. Be aware, one cannot take these out of their sealed. Cannot take these out. They're sealed by C. So that's that bit there. Obviously, so that is that whole page done, which looks awesome. That just makes me think of the Lego movie. So that's that page done. So I've written all my notes. I've done this all at work for you guys, like written all my little notes. So, right. So the next thing we are going to do is throw my pencil on the floor. We're going to do this page. Obviously, I'm not going to... I don't know if I just pulled that. Yeah, I kind of did. It's fine. So I just pulled the like the wire, getting the pencil. Right, so what we're going to do is, I'm going to push this here. We're going to do this page. So this page has the map here, tooth, few teeth, bit of writing, bit of stuff on there. So what I'm going to start doing, first of all, is actually this page here. So that is, it's pretty close to the bottom, actually. So I'm going to start from about here. And I'm going to go to about there. So that is... at 10 centimetres, and obviously it's a square, so 10 should be 10 all round, pretty much. So there is our little box. What I'm actually going to do is, I've noticed this has slightly gone in a bit of an angle. So I'm just going to redo that, just because I'm a little bit anal. Like that. I want it to be perfect. So that is our box for our map, as you can see. So what we're going to do is, I've got myself a printout here just because it makes it easier for me to copy. So again, do this in pencil because it is pretty easy, but if you make mistakes, it's easier for you to rub out. So this is kind of like a really magnified in map. So you've got so I put north, south, east, west. So yeah, just go steady with it and I'm sure you will do absolutely fine. I think it's looking pretty good. do another one. So that is my version of the map. Obviously, it's exactly the same to the normal map. The only thing you've got to do now is we need to do an X, and I do this with like drawing a couple of straight lines because that's the way it looks in the book. And then it's kind of got like these little dots on how to get there, really. And then other than that, I have to look really closely at this. But you've got different numbers. Obviously, I'm not sure if this is how far away it is, etc. So that's 700, 600, 500. This is 600, 500, 400, 300, 400. Let me make sure I do the right line. This one, 400. 500, and that is all of them. Right, so they're obviously the numbers on the map, if that helps you at all. So obviously I'm actually going to go over that part in pen. Also the X and these little bits here do need to be in red, so I'm going to do that in a sec. I just want to where's my black pen? I just want to do the other bits first, so there it is. I don't knock anything. So again, what we're going to do now is we're going to draw the big tooth here. If you're not feeling confident, again, print one of these sheets out. They're pretty easy to find. Just go on Google and type in Gravity Falls Book 3 Truth Telling Teeth page and it will come up. So if you're not confident, cut this out, as I showed you with the previous video, and draw around it. I'm going to use that as a guide. And it will take trial and error to do these kind of things. That's why, as I said, I always draw in pencil, because I can always go back over, rejig things about, and then it doesn't really matter. My little tooth. Well, it's like not a little tooth, is it? It's like hench. And if this video really does help you, and my other videos for my tutorials on how to do book 3 really do help you, please consider subscribing. It really does help so much, and plus you're not going to miss out on any other pages because I'm going to do the full book as well. And also really don't forget to hit that bell button, just because that will mean you definitely won't miss out on any videos that I put up. Obviously I do a gaming part to my channel as well, because I am a really big gamer, so if you want to catch up on that bit too, you can do. But obviously if you're just interested in the Gravity Falls bits, at least that way you're not going to miss out on any of the content and you're not going to miss any pages. I do upload the Gravity Falls pages pretty much every week on a Thursday. It is UK time and it's late UK time, so it's like late evening. So over here it's about like 9 o'clock and I'm doing this. It's just because it's easier for me to do it at this point of the day, because I still live with my parents and they kind of go out. So I've got certain rooms to myself, and that just really helps, because then I'm not in anybody's way. I'm not like, you can't talk in this room because I'm basically doing this. So that is why I do it kind of at this late time. Obviously, as well, if you've got any questions you want to ask me, please feel free to. I do reply to pretty much every comment that goes up on my YouTube channel. So, obviously, yeah, please do. So, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to use my fine liner. And I'm going to write here, which is fig for figure. And it's 81B. Right, I've got writing to do there and there. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to get this red pen. Because part of this tooth is actually coloured in red. So, this middle bit here is actually completely coloured in red. So, obviously we're going to copy that. Which is like that. And then this bit here, which I've already shaded, this bit here. So what you need to do is you need to go around the edge, like so. Like that. And then all this shading here. So basically, we're just doing normal hatching, if I get my words right. So just do lines like so to do that, and we need to do it down here as well, like that. So what I'm actually going to do, and like I said, obviously I don't normally go over my drawings in black, but obviously I'm going to go over this one. I'm not going to go over that in black. I just think it will look funny thinking about it, because obviously these are in pencil and I want that, I want it to still look like it. So, because in the book it's still in pencil. So there is that. Whoop. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to just do the writing up here, and I will tell you what each of those little beadies say. So, right. I need to rummage through my pencil case. Bear with me 2 seconds. Thing is, I already turned this up looking for like another black pen. I want that. I'm really hoping it still works. Does, good, good. Right, so I'm using a red fine liner. Okay, to write the writing here, because it's in red in the book. So, I've got so many bits of paper right now. So that bit of red writing there says, I should have sold the gold instead of burying it. So then this bit of writing here, is in the black fine liner. I just need to move this to, because I need space. Right, so that is in normal black fine liner. I want that. And that needs to just go across here.
So this bit here reads, "The following is a seemingly incredible drawing of a map that holds the location of where these teeth have been buried. Try to find them if you can!" Exclamation point. So that is this bit. So now we've just got a little bit to do here and a little kind of doodle to do there. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to do the writing here first, because there's a little bit of writing and then there's some more teeth that I've got to draw. But I want to get the writing in, then I know how much space I've got. So I'm going to do the writing here. Right, so this bit here reads, "There is something inside the teeth. I believe this is the magical element to them." So then, oh, I need that picture, don't go away. Oh, gotta love Google. So then we're gonna do a couple little doodles, tiny little bit more writing. It's fine, I can just, if it wants to work. My sharpener's not very good. I keep it more because it's perfect for doing those circles. It's amazing, it's like the perfect size. I couldn't have asked for better. Right, so I need this picture. So we're gonna draw three teeth and they are quite close together. Obviously in this gap here. This first one's kind of a weird shape. It kind of reminds me of like, almost like a fish tooth, like a tiger tooth. It's weird to explain. It's kind of short and spiky. And these teeth aren't massive, so obviously try and keep them down to a minimum size, because you're going to want to get three teeth in, plus writing, plus this little thing that needs to go along the bottom. So be wary of this. So we've got two teeth done, and we've just got this other one done, which is to do, sorry, a bit bigger. So it's my final little tooth. I am going to, what have I done with that? There it is. Redo that a little bit, that's better. Right. So there are the three teeth done. So from now on, we're going to hopefully just use mainly this. So what you need to do here is just here, we're going to write fig. What's the next point there? 82. Right, and then we've got this tiny little bit of writing to do. So. So that little bit of writing there just says, these teeth are made of solid gold. Love it. Right. So now along here, I'm going to do it with pencil first actually, is just like this really small like bit of deciphered text to be deciphered, sorry. So first of all, you need to draw yourself a little pyramid. Inside the pyramid, you need to do two lines going that way, and then like that. Then it's like a back, what I call like a backwards E. It's like a weird W. Right, okay, what I'm going to do is redo that. But this line seems to come in a little bit like that. I think I've done it too big. Right, so what I'm actually going to do, first of all, right, we're going to write location here. Location needs to be written here in quite big. Right, I'm mainly doing that because it obviously can't go up to there. So that way I've got a bit of a guide. I've thrown my pen on the floor because obviously I didn't want it anyway. Right, I'm going to redo that mainly because I believe I've done it too big. So it should really be. About that big. So that's quite a difference, obviously. Again, I'm going to re-go over this with black pen, so I'm not overly worried. Obviously, I want it to be reasonably decent because I've got to go over it. But yeah. So after the W, you do an eyeball, and kind of like it's another W, and then two little dots like so. So what we're going to actually quickly do is go over some of this. I don't want that, do I? Right. This won't take me a moment to do, so it's fine. Obviously, be careful when doing this because, like, obviously, lift the ruler up and place it. It sounds so silly, but as I said, if you smudge it because you've literally just drawn pen, you're going to be so upset that you've just smudged it. And I really don't want you to like smudge it and like get upset, so. So that's obviously the border gone round. So what I'm going to do is quickly, you just need to go over this. Don't forget to go, obviously,
the bits around the corner as well, the north east, south and west.
And you'll be able to see hopefully the numbers a little bit better. It's another reason why I like going going over things in like pen on certain things, because then I know that I don't have to make the pencil part like almost like so perfect, because I know I'm gonna go over it. And obviously that final one, this bit here, is gonna be the bit that I need to go over and pay more attention to.
And at the moment, yes, you can see some of the bits where I've gone over it, but that's fine, because I said I'm going to rub those out, and I'll rub those out tomorrow. And don't forget, this is supposed to be red, and these little cute little lines of like some, I guess, like stepping lines, will be red as well. So the last bit I need to go over is this bit at the bottom.
That is these pages completely done, which is awesome. I think they come out really well, actually. I'm really happy with that. So leave me any comments down below, and thank you very much for watching this video. I hope this really helps you with making your Gravity Falls book 3. Obviously, I said if you've got any questions, don't forget to ask them. So I always reply to all my comments, so I will reply to them for you. Obviously, if there's any pages that you want to see, obviously let me know. If there's any other bits I was talking about earlier that you want me to do, so if there's another cartoon on the Disney Channel that, or any other channel, doesn't have to be just Disney, let me know, and I can obviously take a look into it and see if I can start making any of those bits too for you. So don't forget to leave me any comments below. If you like this video, and you're making your book three with me, don't forget to look back through all my other videos. I've put them in a little folder, so they're all together, so you can take a look back and watch all of them if you need any help on any pages. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button, but as well, that little bell button, that will also let you know every time I do a video, so you won't miss out on any of the pages. But thanks very much for watching, guys, and I will see you guys next time. So, see you later. Bye.